Hi everyone, it's Laura Volpez for Studio Katia, and in today's video I'm going to share with you how to create an easy summer card using the Citrus Trimmings stamp set. I started by creating the base for my card and I die cut some white cardstock as well as some pink cardstock. Actually, I just trimmed down the pink cardstock to 4.25 by 5.5 inches. And the die that I used to die cut the white cardstock is the Mini Polka Dots Cover Die by Studio Katia. I then used one of the dies in the dotted patterns set 2 to cut a window out of the center of this polka dot panel. I secured the die with some purple tape and then I ran everything through my die cutting machine. I'm left with a rectangle and a thin frame that I can use on a separate project, and this is how the two panels look once they are layered together. The next step was to work on my images, and here I am using my Misty and the creative corners because the images will hang off this little panel here a little bit, and so the creative corners help me make sure that the paper will not shift and position it in my Misty so that I can go ahead and stamp the images multiple times. In this case, I did not have to reposition my cardstock because it didn't move at all, but if it had, I could put my creative corners back in the Misty, reposition the paper so that it was in exactly the same location as when I had started stamping, and then do my multiple stamping again. The ink that I used is scrapbook.com Premium Hybrid Black Ink, and today I'm going to do some coloring with my Illustrator alcohol markers. I colored the citruses as if these were lemons, oranges, and grapefruits, and then I used some greens for the leaves, and the marker numbers are listed on screen as well as in the blog post that you will find listed in the description box down below. For the lemon, I started with a little bit of a different color combination than the one that I have on screen, but I figured out at the end that I didn't need all those colors, and then I settled on a different one, which is the one that I'm writing down for you if you want to use that as a reference. I am blending the colors on the peel in kind of a smooth way, whereas for the wedges, so for the inside portions of all these citruses, I'm using some brush strokes because if you think about a lemon or an orange or a grapefruit, it doesn't matter, they all are textured, and by adding these brush strokes I am using kind of a quick way to recreate a little bit of that texture. I'm not going to share the entire coloring process because otherwise the video would be too long, and I just thought it would be sufficient to show you each and every color combination and explain to you how I colored in a quick manner, and that would be sufficient for today. I blended the white areas of the citruses with a warm gray marker, and then I used some greens for the leaves. I finished the coloring off camera and this is the final result, and don't worry, it didn't take too long. It seems like there is a lot of coloring, but it was rather quick. At this point, because I wanted to create an inlay die cut effect with that front panel that you can see on the side of the screen, I used again the dotted pattern set to dies to die cut also this panel with the citruses. And to create a little bit of contrast, I ran some black cardstock through my die cutting machine using that same die and created a thin frame. Before gluing everything together, I stamped my sentiment directly on my image. This is part of the Citrus Trimming stamp set and it makes for the perfect all-occasion card. You can personalize this writing a different message inside the card, so it can be a birthday card, a hello card, whatever you need. In order for the sentiment to pop out a little bit more where it overlaps with the images, I went in with a Sakura jelly roll pen and I kind of outlined the sentiment, and then I could go ahead and adhere everything. I'm using my Studio Katia liquid glue to coat the back of this polka dot panel, and then I can go ahead and glue it to the pink cardstock, making sure that it lines up nicely. I didn't use a lot of glue because I didn't want it to ooze out in those little polka dots, but even if it does, don't worry because this glue dries clear, so it will not be possible to see it basically. I also added some glue there at the center, and then I glued down the little frame and then the images, creating this fun inlay die cut effect with this nice contrast from the black frame. I obviously had to add some embellishments, and today I decided to use some pearls, and these ones are lemon burst pearls and ripe persimmon pearls, which I'm gluing down with my Studio Katia liquid glue and an embellishment wand. And then I had to add a little bit more bling to this card using a glitter brush pen that I used to coat all the citruses. The result is quite subtle, but if you tilt the card against the light, all the shimmer shows up and it's really nice. Here is a close-up look at the final result. This card was really quick to make, but I think the result is really pretty and is bright and colorful, and it really screams summer to me. And that's it for today. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope I inspired you to create with the Studio Katia Citrus Trimmings stamp set. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe for more card making inspiration. As always, thank you all so much for stopping by, and have a great day.